Hello everyone. My name is Jamil Hijazin. Hijazin in the English language, or Hijazin in the German language, whatever the pronunciation is. I am a medical doctor from Jordan. I am 28 years old and I am doing my medical residency in Germany since about 15 months. I finished medical school in Jordan in June 2013. Then I came here to Germany in the year after that, after doing my internship here in Jordan. I got the medical license here in Germany in March 2015. And yeah, in this video I will be talking about the steps that I took or other colleagues whom I know of, in order to that we have begun our medical residency in Germany. Okay, I have a blog, amanfromwab.com. My blog is a little bit yet now famous because I've written many posts about the medical specialization in Germany. Medical specialization in Germany is relatively new, 2009-2010. Germany opened its borders, its doors to foreign doctors in order to do medical specialization here. The road is not clear, like in the case of the USA, Canada, Australia, Britain, and so on and so forth. Therefore, there is really a need for such videos. I hope that through my video I will make a little summary about the steps necessary for doing a medical specialization in Germany. Okay, what should I talk about too as an introduction? Okay, right, in this video I will have collected some slides along with some links in order to choose which country you need to go to. You need to read a lot. So through the experience of my blog, I had a Facebook group, Dr. Lane Going to Germany, the name of this Facebook group. People wrote me, people who I've never talked to, and they've written things like, I want to do my medical specialization in Germany. What are the steps? Please tell me. So it's like this person who asked this question. Firstly, I would like to say, asking a question is not a problem. The stupid question is the question that you do not ask. The problem is that these people depend on one person to tell them what are the steps of doing a specialization in a particular country. If you are deciding to do a specialization in any country in this world, you need to read a lot. This is what I did, and this is what I recommend that you do. Through my video, I will place links. I will, like I said, I will try to make a summary. Maybe those people who have a little bit of information about Germany, or who will listen to a particular information that will make them despise this route of specialization, will be able to make a decision. But I would recommend that you read a lot to decide in which you are doing a specialization. You are literally deciding for the course of your life until the end of your life, I think. Okay, I am a little bit excited now because of the amount of questions that I've got. It's no problem. You are welcome to ask questions, but the question that caused me a lot of anger always was, what are the steps? Okay, for those who do not have time to read, maybe this video will be of help to help you decide whether you want to go or not to go to Germany for a medical specialization. Okay, let's start. So, Germany, yes or no? Very quickly, I've created this slide. This should be a discussion, and at the end, it could be subjective. What a person think it is good or not, but Germany is certainly yes. Germany to be in Europe, a great country, a great economy, a great history. Not the whole history of Germany, but talking about the science, about medicine, about engineering, certainly Germany provided a lot to the human history. No steps like USMLE, AMC. This is maybe a disadvantage. Advantage, no steps. In the USMLE, you need to review all the basic medical sciences, biochemistry, biology, physiology, and so on and so forth. Some people do not like these subjects. And after finishing medical school, some people do not have the interest to repeat all of these subjects. So in Germany, I will cover this point later in the this presentation. You need to do a medical knowledge exam, and this does not have to do with the basic medical sciences, maybe pharmacology, pathology a little bit, but it's nothing compared to the USMLE, AMC. These exams, USMLE, AMC, they cost a lot of money. The competition rates are very high. Surgeries are almost impossible to get in these countries. While in Germany, it is easy to get surgery or even minor surgeries. In neurosurgery, this is not impossible for foreign doctors. Less amount of study, of course, if you did not study the basic subjects. However, you need to learn a new language in order to study medicine. And this comes to the no, actually. I'll talk about that later. The costs are fewer in comparison with the USMLE or AMC. Maybe now, because there is a lot of competition, the costs of starting a specialization here is maybe like the USMLE or AMC. USMLE, you need to do interviews. For example, you need to do one exam, the CS in the USA. This costs a lot of money. You need a US clinical experience. The life costs in the USA is, to the best of my knowledge, more expensive than in Germany. Yes, Arabs, you know, because of the problem or the issue of refugees, I do not have, I am not an authority to evaluate the situation. The issue of refugees now in Germany, many of them are Arabs, therefore the hospitals are now searching for Arab doctors, Arab speaking doctors. Not necessarily that you are an Arab. If you can speak Arabic, this is an advantage. They need them. This will save the hospitals the fees of asking for translators. Also, this is very important. If you know foreign languages, French, for example, Russian, these are languages that are spoken by many foreigners and immigrants here in Germany. So this would be of an advantage for your application here in Germany. Not all people here in Germany speak German. I'm talking, of course, about the immigrants and ironically some people who have been living here since many years. No, this is the only disadvantage in my opinion. It is the language. To study medicine in another language other than English, it's not. I always say so this sentence to the Germans because I fear that they might be offended by saying that. It's not about the German language, it's about studying medicine in any language other than English. In research, one says there is a saying that says, publish in English or perish. And you will notice it when you come here, the amount of medical information, a Wikipedia article, for example, about depression in Germany, in German, or a Wikipedia article about depression in English, no comparison, 3, 4, 5 times bigger. The textbooks in German are nothing to be compared. Not nothing, but the English language textbooks are certainly used all over the world. The language of research is English. This is the problem. It would be perfect here in Germany. The situation would be perfect if one had only to talk with the patients in German and the documentation and the textbooks are in English. However, this is not the situation. The learning the language takes a lot of time. And as you've just noticed it, when you speak English, you start mixing English and German words. Your English does not become... better when you are in Germany. Many doctors, the majority of as I've seen, they do not speak good English. English is not taught as not concentrated upon in the schools. Students have the choice to learn Spanish, French, English, and so on and so forth. Maybe this is the situation is now another thing, but my experience until now, English, your English will not be better in Germany. In Germany, on the other hand, it will be worse because, as I explained, the two languages mixed together. And ask anyone who ranked German, and he could speak before that good English, and he will tell you how worse his English became. I placed this slide because this problem is my university recognized in Germany. I've never heard about it. When I'm talking about doctors from Jordan, Egypt, Syria, and Arab doctors that are here in Germany, most universities in the European Union, I think all universities are recognized. To be honest with you, I do not know if any universities in this world are not recognized in Germany. I think some could be. You can Google that. I have no idea which universities are recognized or not recognized. However, this is not a topic or an issue. If you are going to do your residency in Germany, I think for most, this is not a problem. If you are not sure, or if you are the first from your university to be aiming at a residency in Germany, maybe you could check if your university and your medical degree is, your university will come to the degree later, recognized in Germany. The steps, there are 8 steps that one should take in order to get a job here in Germany. The steps may be 5 instead of 7. The order might be different. However, this is not important, the order in which, the sequence in which the things happen. You need to all doctors need to, most doctors will need to go most of these steps. I will tell you which ones you need to go through. Medical degree, of course, you'll start with a medical degree, 5-6 years. This is no problem in Germany. Medical schools last for 5 years, not 6 years like in my country, Jordan, or in Egypt or Syria, and many other Arab countries. In Germany, 5 years medical school, then 1 year internship here. This medical degree, you need to have it. 5 or 6, this is no problem. I've never heard it is a problem. Internship here. In Arab countries, you must do in Syria, I think you do not need to do that. However, you need to do an internship here after your medical school. This year of training, okay, and one is not getting a full salary, etc. Some doctors sent me messages saying in Ukraine, I think, or in China, they do not do an internship here. In Germany, when you apply for the medical license, the document proving that you did an internship here is required. If you did not do it, is a practical experience of 2 or 3 years enough? Or what should I do? It is like compatible, or that's one of the situation when you don't know the German word but not the English word. It's like if you, for example, you did if you worked for 2 years, is this compatible? Equal. Equivalent to a practices year, an internship here in Germany. I do not know. However, for many, they could solve this problem. How? I don't know. But you need 1 year of internship. How? I cannot help. You can maybe ask in the groups. Can you do this internship here in Germany? Yes. But I know so few people who did that. It is possible, but it's a little bit maybe complicated. I don't know the how is that done. So please do not ask me. In the groups, Google, you can maybe find an answer. Learn the language, German language. Some people start to learn the German language in the 3rd, 4th year of medical school. Some already know it before medical school, in my case, and in the case of many doctors in Jordan, they start to learn it about after medical school. I started learning it after my and during my internship here after my I graduated there are levels of the European languages. There is a scale A1, A2, B2, B1, B2. You need to reach the level B2. There are two other levels, C1, C2. C2 is mother speaker. B2 is enough. However, I will mention this information now. B2 is nothing. You need at least C1. Some universities, this is rare, universities, hospitals, they say C2 or will not read your application. However, B2 is enough. Some doctors get a job still with a B2. However, this is very important in order to tell you how more complicated this situation now is. Before, with 4 or 5 years, doctors with a level of B1, B1 or B2, they could get easily a job. Now, because the competition is high, it is not more the situation. Travel to Germany for this is a problem for nationals of countries outside of the European Union. For us to get here in Germany, you need a visa, language course, or a hospitation. A hospitation, it's not an internship. I'm sorry, this is the wrong word. It is like an internship. It's like a period of training after finishing medical school. It is like observership in the English language. Observership is like shadowing. You are not allowed to do anything in the hospital. You are allowed only to watch. There is another internship, observership, clerkship. Maybe the word is clerkship. A clerkship is a hospitation. You in a hospitation, you work in a hospital, you do the rotations with the doctors, you withdraw blood. Yeah, not in all hospitals. Some hospitals say you are not allowed to withdraw blood if you are not you have a medical license. However, this is how you get to Germany, a hospitation internship. I've created slides about these steps. I will go over them. I'm sorry. One into total of 6 years internship year, right? A must. Learn the language. Back to the language. Go to institute. Take institutes. They are the best in Jordan. In many countries in the world, there is a Goethe Institute. I advise that you study German in this center because the teachers are mother speakers or fast mother like mother speakers. C2 rare requested, and it is rare. This certificate is rare. Also. Rare got also. I have never heard about a doctor who have the C2 certificate, C1, B2, and so on and so forth. There are some centers where you can go and buy the certificate. Yes, there are such things in Germany. You pay 400-500 euros and you'll get C1, B2 certificate. Of course, this is dangerous. You are talking about a medical license. How to learn German? Teaching center. This is another slide. How to learn German? Some ask teaching center the best. Self learning. You save a lot of money. However, it is not effective like in a teaching center. Online teaching. Here is a link to an online German school. If you have enough money and you do not have time, flexible time to go to a center, a German native speaker can teach you German about 20 euros, between 18 to 20 euros per 60 minutes, for 60 minutes. This is a school I know. Maybe there are other schools that are cheaper. This school is now more expensive. In the beginning, it was they started, it was before 2 years, maybe 14, 16 euros. Now it is much more expensive. My experience about learning the German language outside of Germany, you can read it here. An interesting way to learn the German language, you can read it here. Costs about 2,000 to 3,000 euros. You can read the details here. Tilkbitzweit is medical exam. You can read about this exam here. This exam is required to apply for the medical license in one German state, at least it is Hessen. You can read about it in this post in my blog. Traveling to Germany, you register yourself in a language school, language institute, based on your acceptance in the language school. You can apply for the visa. Hospitation, you apply for a clinical attachment, or someone helps you to get a hospitation. This is an effective way. You can get an invitation, and you can through it get a visum. The visa is not enough. Visum is the German word. The visa is not enough. Easy. There are required papers. You can read about my experience here. The visa sometimes is rejected in Jordan. At least I was told in Egypt it is very easy. I don't know about the situation from other countries. In Jordan, I know a colleague who applied for the visa 3-4 times, maybe got rejected always, and at the end he came here to Germany. He got his medical license and he began his medical residence, I think, in surgery. So this was a very interesting case, because I've always feared that I would not get the visa from the first time. I got it luckily, and yeah, it is a little bit hard in Jordan. I don't know why. Maybe now the situation is something another. But this shows you how important it is that you control your papers and make sure that you are not using false document. You are not using not legal papers, like some doctors who buy language certificates. Apply for the approbation. This is the most important thing. A colleague of mine said a very beautiful sentence. The two important the two important things that you need to pass in order to say that you have reached your goal of starting a medical residency are two things: the visa, getting here to Germany, and the other thing is the approbation. This is the German language word for German medical license. Getting the German medical license is the most important step. Without a medical license, you are nothing. You are not a doctor. Even if you have a certificate, this is not recognized in Germany. The process of recognition of the medical license, of getting the medical license, this is another disadvantage in Germany. I need to say that, because in USA, Canada, and so on and so forth, there is a system. You know the exams, you know the books. There is in the USA, for the 50 states or 51 states, I always forget how many states are there. However, I think 50. There are defined steps in Germany. Defined steps for the 50 states. In Germany, there are 17 states, 23 or 24 medical license authorities, Approbation Behörden. And each authority has its system, has its required papers, how easy you can get the approbation there. So your decision to come to Germany should be very wise. You should ask in which medical license authority, not in which state, in which medical license authority your university degrees are recognized. This is a problem for graduates from outside the European Union. For graduates from the universities inside of the European Union, independent of their nationalities, they do not need to go through hard steps or a medical knowledge test. They need only to apply for the German medical license, and they will get it either directly in some authorities or indirectly after doing a medical language test. I will talk about it later. For graduates from outside of the European Union, for example, in Jordan, nine doctors from my batch got our approbation from Arnsberg. and thousands of Arab doctors. In the region where I work, Bezirks Regierung Arnsberg, the district Regierung of Arnsberg, this is one medical license authority in the German state of North Rhine-Westphalia. This beautiful German state, it is population about 80 million now. There are five medical authorities in five in Arnsberg, Köln, Düsseldorf, Detmold, and there is Munster, maybe Munster. Munster, I think, yeah, five authorities, and each one of them has different procedures, different difficulty indeed dealing with foreign doctors. Arnsberg, it is very friendly with Arab doctors. Many doctors get their recognition of Gleichwertigkeit. That means you apply for the approbation and they say your medical, what you studied in Jordan, in Syria, in Egypt, in Pakistan, whatever, is equal to what medical students here in Germany study, and therefore we need only to prove to exam your medical, your German medical language, okay? It is a little bit complicated. I do not know if you have understood everything. The summary, if you read this article, you'll understand that better. So the recognition of your medical studies is not direct. Even for graduates of Arab countries in this Arnsberg, in this district government, it is not 100% guaranteed. Some student doctors from the same batch, from the same same university, of course, same batch, so one gets, they have studied the same things. One gets a Gleichwertigkeit equal and the other, and he will need only to get to do a medical language exam. The other get nicht gleich, and he will need to do a medical knowledge test, which is much more harder than a simple language exam. And this is this problem. Okay, that was my feeling as I applied with my colleagues. One of them got nicht gleich, also not equal. And the whole side is time for me, for my colleagues. Will we get equal or not equal? And this whole story, of course, some people get not equal, and they will do Gutachtung. Also, this means you will say no, I did this and this and this, and here is a correction, or here is an evidence that I did that and did that, and so on and so forth. It is complicated. It is the world is easy, or it is heaven on earth. The situation is when you get directly the Gleichwertigkeit, and then you will need to do a language test. It is complicated. I hope that you understood something. Like I said in this article, you want to quickly get the approbation and understand more. What are the required documents for applying for the approbation? Yeah, 23 or 24 medical license authorities. However, there are similarities in the papers required for applying for the approbation. You can see my experiences in Arnsberg, and you can see the required documents there. The list is not up to date. I've lastly updated it at least before 1 year. There are a little changes, I think. However, you can easily and comfortably prepare your documents according to it. I think there are no changes. The place of translation, this is a problem most times inside of Germany, outside of Germany. Do you need a legalization from the German embassy in your country, or you do not need it? Of course, you will need, you read all about the details here. For graduates of the European Union, some authorities, for if someone is listening to me in Oberbayern, I think you need only a job contract, and you'll get directly the approbation in Sachsen. For Arab doctors in Arnsberg, you need to do a medical language test in Sachsen. Maybe this changes. You need now to do a medical language test, but before 2 or 3 months in the last years, one did get the approbation directly. In these two articles, I hope that you will understand the situation correctly. Approbation behorden, 23 or 24, like I said. What are these authorities? You can see that in these links. I can speak more about that, but like I said, the previous two articles, and here you can see a list of the article, the authorities, and in this authorities, in the website of these authorities, you can see the details which papers they require. Fachsprachenprüfung, this exam you need to do it before getting the medical license. If your medical certificate, your bachelor degree was just to be equal, like I said. Full details about this exam, not full details, not full details. Things change. I'm itching my hair a lot. I'm using a hair gel. I think I should not use it. And I run for 30 minutes or 20 minutes, so this explains it. But I need to finish this video. I promised someone that I need to do it. I'm sorry. Okay, back to the video. The Fachsprachenprüfung. You can read about the details about it here, and this is a video 40 minutes. Actually, it is very famous now on YouTube. I think I've got many likes. This is a summary of months of learning of the medical German language, and I think you will profit from it. The details and the video, you can see it in this post. Kenntnisprüfung, like I said, if you're in some authorities, you'll need in Berlin, for example, you need 100%, not 100%, but maybe it is 90%. I don't know if there are exceptions, but you need to do a medical language test in Baden-Württemberg, for example. The medical language knowledge test, I'm sorry, Kenntnisprüfung in German, the word for it. It is, like I said, 23 authorities, different procedures, and the difficulty of the exam, of this exam, is different according to the German state. In some German states, it's very easy. You can do it in 1 or 2 months of preparation, and it is like history. Do an examination, general questions, and some others. In Baden-Württemberg, you will need to do a special course, 6,000 euros in this academy. It is now very famous here in Germany. You will pay 6,000 euros. You will get a training 3-4 months maybe, and then you will do the exam. Few people, I don't know, but a colleague of mine did get the appropriation through this academy. He studied there and then did the exam. And he was he got the approbation. This is a one way of getting the medical the German medical license. In other German states, like I said, Arnsberg, you can come here, apply for the approbation, then wait. If you are equal, not equal, then do a medical language test. This lasts at least 6-7 months. And another problem here, you need a hospitation training before you could apply for the approbation. This is interesting. In America, in the USA, you do not need to get a job contract in order to do the exams. Here in Germany, in most of the medical license authorities, you'll need a job contract a job contract in order to apply for the approbation. Preparation courses, this one is from the charity. This is the largest the hospital building in Europe. 2,300 euros. Learn online, you can. This is a cheap method. You can really learn through this German website, buy books. It's not hard to prepare for the exam. This site is interesting. You could get a trial of 7 days. Applying for a job, some people do it like this way. The most, until recently, they came here to Germany, then they started to send applications for a job. You get the job, then you apply for the approbation, the German medical license, and you will get a temporary license, and 1.5 years, 2 years, and during this period you could prepare yourself for the medical language test. Or maybe you'll be lucky and you'll get a job contract in Sachsen and get the approbation directly. But like I said, it's now, the situation is now different. You'll need to do the medical language test now. My recommendation, and logically it is better to invest your time studying the German language, doing applying for the approbation if you could do that in Arnsberg or not, or in any other authorities where you could apply without a job contract, without with an Anmeldung, and wait to do to see if you are equal or not equal. If you are equal, you will need only to then to do the medical language test, and then you will have the approbation, and then applying for a job is then an easy task. But if you are, you do not have the approbation, many hospitals write in their advertisement, we only accept applications from doctors who already have the medical license. So it is different how you how doctors use the which strategy the doctors use. I recommend studying the German language. Like I said, competition is now high. Improve your language. Stay in one place. Study the language, get to know some Germans, get to know the culture, the system in the hospital, do an observership or a clerkship. This will be very helpful for your CV, and then you can start applying for a job. There are many good websites. You can see them here in my blog and in the other top two websites, salaries. There are many contracts for doctors here in Germany. The most common one is from the Marburger Bund. This is like a Bund is like association for doctors, like association that protects the rights of doctors. I do not know the English word exactly. Verbund. It is like things together. Verbund. Maybe you could help me with a comment. However, I would like to talk about that here. This is my job contract, and 4,000 of doctors in Germany. The number of doctors in Germany is about more than 370,000. These are the statistics of last year. There is a you could see the statistics through a link in my blog. Search about the statistics of medical doctors in Germany, or search in Google. You will, if you are interested to see the number of doctors, their nationalities here in Germany. Back to the salaries of doctors here in Germany. This is an important topic. How much does a doctor get? Actually, in comparison with America, Canada, Australia, it is maybe 50%, 70%, I don't know, but certainly less than in these countries. But the life here is in Germany, it's like cheaper than in Canada or in Germany or in Australia. In Geldgruppe, I don't know the translation, but it's like here are the residents, here are the Facharzt, specialist, then after the specialist comes Oberarzt. It's like a leading specialist, maybe the word in English. And then there are four rankings. In the army, 10, 12 rankings for doctors in German hospitals, four rankings, residents, assistant Arzt, Oberarzt, Facharzt, specialist, then comes if you are promoted, you are an Oberarzt, and then a Chefarzt. The salaries are different according to your level. Residents in the first year gets brutto. This is your salary before the taxes in Germany. Maybe for single people in Germany, you will get 65% approximately of this amount of money. 4,000 euros, 198. Maybe it is about, for me, I was single, and it depends on the German state. For me here, North Rhine-Westphalia, it was 2,400 plus euros, what you get in your pocket. Of course, this money goes for the health insurance, for rent, for your salary that you will get after you are renter. Yeah, you see, once forget the English words. Okay, I used to speak English more fluently than this, and you can see some videos of me in my video in my channel, and yeah, a lot of Abschweichungen. What is the word in English? I've talked about many sub-subjects. Okay, back to the topic. Digressions, a lot of digressions. If you come into the second year, your salary will be higher. As a specialist, 5,500, maybe 3,200. But in Germany, don't be afraid. You are asked to do Schichtdienst, also you are asked to work in the night on weekend, and shift works. And for this work, you are getting paid for each hour of it. You get about here is the slide. Assistant hours, Oberarzt, Fach hours, Oberarzt, shift hours. For an assistant hours, you will get 72 euros per hour. This is the Marburger Bond. I forgot to mention, this is almost similar to other. There is fast no difference. The difference is in the amount of money is not very big between the different contracts. If you are after 6 years, some people never reach the level of specialist. They will remain as residents for whatever reason. You will get after this in the 6 years, and after that only in 29 euros per hour. This is brought to netto. The net what you get in your pocket is about 14 euros 15 euros. So on Saturday, if you work for 24 hours, you will get go to your house with about 350 euros. If you not work in the night, you will get extra money, 5 euros per hour night. It means from 9 p.m. until 6 p.m. If you work on Christmas or in holidays, you will get also extra money. So it is not bad what amount of money you get in internal medicine and so on. Surgery, after a few months, 6-7 months, when you start to do about 50-60 hours of shift work, your salary will reach easily 3,200-500. Some doctors who are married, if you are married in Germany, you will get the taxes are fewer, and you will get more money in your pocket. So this was the salary. Suggested readings back, colleagues, if you are deciding to come to Germany, this is a decision for the rest of your life. You are going to learn a new language in order to do a medical specialization, and this is not easy. Some doctors I knew, they learned German in Jordan for 18 months. They spent 2,000, 3,000 euros. They came here, they registered for language courses, tickets, hotels, and so on and so forth. And then they decided the German language is very hard. I do not like the German language. I do not like to learn a new language to study medicine. And they go back to Jordan, to their home countries. So please read about it. It's not about asking a question to a blogger or in a Facebook group. Please read about this route or any other route of specialization you are deciding about. Really, it is like this, how it is a major shift in your life. It is a milestone. So please read about it. In my blog, I wrote many articles. I do not write anymore since I did not write anymore since months. Time is money. When you come here, you'll understand that. You will start, if you have free time, you can do Schichtdienst, you can do shift work, you can get 15 euros per hour. So you can, this was in my blog, I've always written about many things, but here in Germany, time is money. 8 hours writing an article in my blog took me 4 hours. This is about 60 euros. So this is why I started, did not write any more about the specialization in Germany or any other things. And I'm sorry too for many people who sent me messages. I cannot answer them. There are some people who could help you. I will tell you about one person right now. Other suggested readings, please read these two articles in my blog. There are many comments, many questions that were posted to these two articles. and I've answered them. They will help you get a better idea. This Marburger Bund, this very famous Bund. I don't know yet the word for a Bund. 19 frequently asked questions, very interesting, very this is an authority, so you should trust them. Facebook group, I established a Facebook group. It has now more than 6,000 members. I stepped down from the administration. A very nice person called Teddy Kabel, a German man, who helped me, and thousands and hundreds of tens, I don't know how many, I think hundreds by now. He helped a lot of people, foreign doctors, starting with their medical specialization. He is now the administrator. You can join this group, post your questions. But please, this was irritating as I started this. Some people ask questions before reading anything. If you are a specialist, you do not have a time, post the question. I'm not against that. Maybe there are people who are ready to help you. But again, reading is maybe at least 19 frequently asked questions. Some posts in my blog for a few hours, you will get a good idea, and then you will not go into a group and ask a question. What is approbation or order? What is hospitation? Can you please tell me what is a hospitation? So maybe you could understand now. These are like basics. The basics of the medical specialization in Germany. Two great blogs. These are Indian doctors. I think both are Indians. Very great. I recommend reading them. One of them, I think the first one, the second one, one of them is doing a great job. So his my blog, I've written many things, but it's like he started where I ended. He wrote about many topics, but he have many articles, more articles than I have, and he's talking about topics that I did not address in my blog. For example, the salaries of doctors in Germany. In one of these blogs, this is discussed. So read these German blogs. Maybe you will get an idea about the life of a medical doctor in Germany. It is interesting. As I was in medical school, I used to read blogs of residents in the USA. And that helped me to understand the medical system in American hospitals. I am now in Germany, and I do not regret it, at least until now. Facebook groups. There are many groups: the Egyptian doctors, Syrian doctors, Jordanian doctors, Greek doctors. Tens of groups, you can see them in this post in my blog, and I forget to post the link to that. Unfortunately, I will post that, and I will correct the presentation, and I will post it in the comments or in the description section of my video. The most two important groups: Egyptian doctors. Some posts are in Arabic, you cannot understand anything, but some posts are in German. Maybe you'll get a good idea. The Syrian doctor in Germany, almost everything is in German. So, and I've told you about a German person who could help you, Teddy Kabel, for those people who do not have time. You can contact him. He's not asking for a lot of money. He did that for free. I do not have any conflict of interest. He even sent me a message regarding his opinion if I should mention his name or not. I'm doing that. You can ask him. He is asking for a little amount of money for his help. He's now an expert, and like I said, he's now the administrator of my previous group, Doctors Going to Germany. He's doing a great job in his group. The members of this group are now 7,000. Some hard questions are always posted, like I did not cover that in my blog and in my video. Doctors who have experience, does this matter? Could this be recognized in Germany? Yes. How is that? Approximately, I cannot help you. For the process of Gleichwertigkeit, that your medical study is judged to be equal, read the articles in my blog. I've covered that. This great blog is now, I like it. It's in English language and German. As I used to be the administrator administrator, I had a rule that everything should be either in German or English, but it seems now some post in Arabic. However, the majority is in are English or in German. This video is a little bit Durcheinander, they say in German. It is not, maybe not very good. I'm a little bit tired, but like I said, I've had the idea of doing this video since months, and doing it is better than not doing it. So I hope that you will get an idea about the medical specialization in Germany. Your feedback is more than welcome. Maybe I would be able, based on the feedback, to make a new video to correct any mistakes that I said, and to answer other questions that I could ask. So colleagues, I'm happy that I've finally finished this video and finished this idea of creating a video about medical specialization in Germany. I wish you a lot of reading, that you will read a lot, and if you decided on Germany or in USA or whatever, it is subjective at the end. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. It is you who decide what is best for you, which country is the best for you. Read about advantages and disadvantages of each country, each destination. And at the end, I hope that you will choose the correct destination for you, and you will not regret that years later or months later. Yeah, thank you, and good luck. Tschüss.